Hello, good evening.
Good evening, everyone.
All right, good evening, Juan. How are you today?
Good night. Good night.
Night, mister. Okay, so everybody's getting connected. We got a lot of things and information to share today. So welcome to this new video conference. So basically one more besides this one, and we have ended up week number two. So basically we are going to be in the middle of the module in this case. That's really, really, really interesting. Like to be basically in the middle of this module. That's like time very, very, very fast. So good evening, everyone. So it's 8 o'clock. So we're gonna start with the ones that you have right now. Okay, so it's 8:01. So I officially give the welcome to all of you to this video conference number 9, okay? So good evening, everybody. Let's start first with the attendance list before moving to the topic for today, right? So let's start with the attendance list, and then we can have the short feedback that we have from previous class. So let's see, Carla Lisette, not here. Carlos Eduardo. Okay, Carlos Eduardo.
Hello.
Ah, okay. You're there.
Present.
Okay, thank you, mister. Dalila Abigail, I mean, let me see. Carlos Gualberto.
Present.
Okay, thank you. Dalila Abigail, here. Dania Rebeca. All right, she's not connected yet. Eric Jonathan. Okay, not connected yet. Let's see, Giovanni Pineda.
Present.
Okay, thank you. Giovanni Ramirez. Oh, not here yet. Okay. Juan Carlos Palacios. Juan Carlos Palacios. Okay, no here. Juan Carlos Peña.
I'm here.
Okay, thank you. Juan Osmel.
Over here.
Thank you. Kevin Antonio. All right, not here yet. Marlon Alberto. Okay, not here yet. Then I have Miguel Angel.
Present, teacher.
Okay, thank you, Miguel. Nancy Yvette. Okay, not here, Nancy. Omar Alfredo. Okay, no here yet. Silvia Suleima.
Present.
Okay, thank you, Silvia. Suleima Veronica. Okay, not here yet. And Walter Daniel. Okay, not here yet. Okay, cool. So we're gonna start with the things that I told you like right now. Okay, Juan Carlos Palacios is coming up. All right, mister, I'm going to include you here. Let me see where is your list.
Hi, teacher.
Hi.
Llegando.
Okay, Carla. I'm gonna take it in consideration. Okay. All right, you're included in the list. Perfect. So let's start having a review from the topic that we were discussing last class, okay?
Good evening, teacher.
Okay, good evening, mister. Let's see your... Okay, I'm gonna include you in the list, Kevin. No, your brother is not here, right, Giovanni?
Yes.
Okay, cool. Let's see, I'm gonna include you here. Okay, cool. So as I told you, let's start with the things that we were practicing yesterday. Now, let's have HR feedback from the topic that we were discussing last class. Okay, mister. Good evening. I'm including you in the attendance list. Let me see, Kevin Antonio. Okay, here. All right, you're already in the list, Kevin. Cool, as I told you, we're gonna start with this thing. Let me see. All right, as I told you, we're gonna start with a short thing for like right now. So today is going to be the video conference number 9. Okay, so what's today's topic? Today's topic is going to be vocabulary practice, okay? Related to daily routines, okay? So today and tomorrow, it's going to be about activities related to daily routines. Why? Because this is like kind of interesting topic that we need to practice, okay? How we can easily talk about our daily routine, my daily routine, or a friend daily routine, okay? So entonces hay diferentes perspectivas en las cuales nosotros podemos mencionar las actividades que nosotros hacemos durante el día, todos los días, o mencionar las actividades que otro compañero de trabajo hace o un miembro de la familia, okay? So that's the way how we're gonna be working. Ayer básicamente tuvimos un ello. So today we're gonna do some exercises. We're gonna practice a conversation and stuff like that. All right. Okay, who got the microphone on? All right, cool. So let's start. So the class agenda, this is pretty much what we are going to be doing today. So we're gonna do a review from previous class. Vamos a tener un pequeño repaso de la clase anterior. Okay, that's pretty much how we start the class. Then we're going to have a practice, okay, with a conversation related to daily activities. That's another point that we are going to be working on. Then we're gonna have a practice, okay, of vocabulary related to daily routines. What does this mean? Significa que vamos a tener vocabulario adicional que podemos incluir cuando mencionamos nuestras actividades cotidianas, por así decirlas, o nuestros pasatiempos. Okay, what do we generally do on weekdays? What do we generally do on a very, very common day? So that's part of what we are going to be talking today in this section. And then obviously we're gonna start with some activities, especially on the manual. Okay, we're gonna be working on the manual. And that's pretty much what we're gonna be doing, okay? But let's start with the first point of the agenda, the review from previous class. What do we remember from yesterday's class, people? Okay, any volunteer that tell me, what do you remember from last class? What were we practicing? ¿Qué estuvimos viendo la clase pasada? ¿Qué recordamos? We're gonna start with that. Vamos a comenzar con ello. Hi. Okay, Can somebody tell me what we were practicing yesterday? What were we doing yesterday?
Hi, teacher.
Hi. Juan, tell me.
We learned to make short answer using do and dash.
Uh-huh.
We practice about daily activities.
Ah, okay, very good. All right, thank you, Juan. Very nice. So Juan said something very interesting. We were practicing questions with do and does. Okay, just no questions in simple present. That was part of from yesterday's topic. Okay, now Juan Carlos.
Let me share.
All right, cool. Juan Carlos, let's see if you remember about that topic. I want you to ask one question in third person to Carlos Gualberto.
Okay. And the last question, doesn't, I remember in negative and positive.
Okay. But what do I want right now, Juan Carlos, is you to give me an you to ask basically a question to Carlos Gualberto about anything using any verb. The verb that you want. Quiero que le haga una pregunta a él utilizando la tercera persona.
Okay. Do you, Juan Carlos?
Third person, Juan Carlos.
Yeah. Does Juan Carlos or teacher?
Okay. Ajá. Es que había comenzado con do, por eso decía.
Yeah. Okay. Sorry.
Okay.
Does Juan Carlos or teacher?
Nah. Okay. Easy, right?
I'll repeat.
Oh my God, Dios, Carlos. Okay. Se la valgo. Okay, mister, repeat the question.
Repeat question, okay.
Yeah.
Does Juan Carlos, our teacher?
Why don't we change the question, Juan Carlos?
No. Does Juan Carlos
but over. Because we need a verb, Juan Carlos, in there. We need a verb, Juan, in there. Porque si buscamos el verbo en esa pregunta, ¿dónde está?
Okay, entonces...
just add the verb teach. Agreguemos el verbo teach.
Okay. Does Juan Carlos teach English?
Okay. Uh-huh.
Yes, he does.
Are you sure it's like that, Carlos? ¿Estás seguro de su respuesta?
Yes.
Are you sure? Very sure. Yes or no?
Yes.
Okay.
I'm grown.
No, es que yo como lo veía así como, lo sentía como con dudas, por eso le estaba preguntando si estaba realmente seguro. Yeah, that's correct. Thank you, Juan Carlos. Okay. All right.
You're welcome.
Okay, thank you, Carlos, for that. Okay. Silvia, Suleyma, let's see if we remember those questions in first person and using plurals, okay? Silvia, I want you to ask one question to your classmate, Dania, using first person. Ask a very, very direct question to Dania. using do.
Okay. Do you live in Chalchuapa?
Nah, okay.
Yes, I do.
Ah, really? Do you live in Chalchuapa, Dania?
Sí. Yes.
¿Cómo que sí, Dania? Has to be yes. Okay, cool. Acceptable. Very nice. So let's see. Let's start. So thank you, Silvia, and thank you, Dania. Omar. Start with you, Omar.
Okay. Hi, teacher.
Mister. Hi.
Good evening.
Okay, good evening, mister. Good. Omar, si yo tengo un verbo que termina en O y lo quiero pasar a una oración en tercera persona o pregunta, ¿qué le debo agregar al verbo principal?
No.
Solo ese, eso necesito.
¿Es? ¿Es?
¿De S?
Yes.
Todo verbo que termine en O, en tercera persona le agregamos la S.
Yes. Sí, yes, teacher.
Are you sure?
Yes.
Ah, okay. Espéreme ahí. Let me see. Kevin, ¿apoya a Omar? Do you agree with him?
Repeat.
Do you agree with Omar? ¿Está de acuerdo con lo que Omar dijo? Que todo verbo que termina en O, en tercera persona, en presente simple, le agregamos una S.
No.
No, okay. Okay, you got yes or no. You said no. Why? Why not? Why not, Kevin? Okay. You just remember that no, but you don't remember. Okay, okay, okay. I got you, Kevin. Okay. Let's see, Omar.
Yes, teacher.
Did you continue with the idea that if you get a bird that ends in O, you just add an S?
I don't understand, teacher.
Okay, okay, okay. Continuamos todavía con que todo verbo que termine en O, en tercera persona o en singular, agregamos una S.
Yes, teacher.
Creo. Did you think? Okay, Omar. I'm gonna put an example, Omar. Tenemos el verbo do. Right?
Yes.
Verbo que termina en O. Okay. Ajá. Okay. Entonces, si hágame esta oración, Omar. Ella hace su tarea.
Okay. Does she make?
No. Una oración con el verbo do. Una oración afirmativa. Remember affirmative sentences?
Do you make?
No question, Omar. Positive sentence. Yes, positive sentence. Una oración positiva, se lo voy a poner como ejemplo. I live in San Miguel. Esa es una oración positiva. Utilizo el verbo okay. Live. Ahora, yo le pido un
make.
Ahora, yo le pido que me haga una oración con el verbo do, pero en tercera persona. Oración. ¿Ok?
She do make... don't remember lo último. Ella hace, me dice, ella...
Su tarea. Ok, pero ya no necesita el verbo make, Omar, porque ya tenemos do. Do es hacer, cuando hace una acción. ¿Ok? Okay?
She do homework.
Her homework. All right, Omar. Ahora bien, quiero que me haga una pregunta. I want you to ask a question using the same structure. Quiero que con la misma, estructura, las mismas palabras, me formule una pregunta. ¿Hace ella su tarea? Hágame esa pregunta, por favor. ¿En inglés?
Does she homework?
Repítala otra vez.
Does she her homework?
¿Y el verbo dónde lo colocamos, Omar?
Does she make?
Sería do.
No. Do.
Yes.
I don't know, teacher. Ahí me bloqueé.
Ok, donde pone el verbo make, pongamos el verbo do.
Does she do?
Yes.
Does she do her homework?
Ajá, exactly. Does she do her homework? Ahí ya tenemos. ¿Hace ella su tarea? Ahora bien, ¿qué es does, Omar? ¿De dónde viene does?
Does es como el auxiliar. Auxiliar.
Ajá, ajá. Es un verbo auxiliar. ¿Y es la tercera persona de qué verbo, Omar?
He, she, it.
Ajá. Pero el verbo, vaya, ese no es la forma base del verbo. ¿Cuál es la forma base de ese verbo does, Omar?
Do.
Ah, entonces quiere decir que do. Ah, pero Omar, usted me dijo que se le agrega S. Y ahí tiene ES.
Okay, ES.
Ah, very good. So you see, a eso quería que llegara. Good. Okay. So, en ese caso, recordemos, todo verbo que termina en O se le agrega ES. Ejemplo, otro ejemplo, el verbo go. Entonces, el verbo go le agregamos ES en tercera persona. She goes to the supermarket. Ahí ya va la E y la S incluidas cuando estamos en tercera persona. ¿Ok? Just keep that in mind. Okay. All right. ¿Cuáles son las otras excepciones? Cuando los verbos que terminan en doble S, double S, SH, CH, X, ¿ok? Todos esos verbos que tienen esa terminación, se les agrega ES en presente simple, tercera persona. ¿Ok? Just keep that in mind, everybody. Right? Remember that. Entonces tenemos el verbo watch. Termina en CH. Watch. I watch television. Verbo en forma base. Pero cuando ya decimos he watches television, so you see, ya ahí agregamos la E y la S al verbo principal. He watches television. ¿Ok? So keep that in mind. All right? Entonces tenemos que tener bien presente esas terminaciones, ¿ok? Que toda vez que tengamos un verbo que tenga esas terminaciones, what happens? Agregamos ES cuando ya vamos a hablar sobre he, she, and it, or singular nouns, cuando hablamos de un nombre propio, ¿ok? Just keep that in mind. Good. So this is part of a brief, very brief feedback from the previous topic. Okay, now, what are we going to do? I think most of you have joined. Bien, habemos, let me see how many we are. 18. Ah, that's cool. Estamos muy bien ahorita en parejas. Cool. What are we going to do like right now? Vamos a hacer una práctica de una conversación. I want to see how much we have retained. So we're going to practice a conversation. This is going to be a short conversation. Okay. La conversación es tomada del manual, from the manual. So, si tienen el manual a la mano, los que lo han impreso, that's okay, that's nice. Si no, look, this is the conversation, okay?
The page, teacher.
All right, the page of this one, it's page, I think it's page 22. If I'm not wrong, if I'm not mistaken, it's page 22. Yeah, it's a conversation between Janet and Cindy. Confírmenme si esa es la página, pero tiene, tendría que, ya. Yeah. The ones
that 21.
Ah, 21. Okay, good. Perfect. I was saying 22. Okay. From the ones that got the manuals, let's do it that way, okay? Los que tienen el manual impreso, perfecto. La podemos estar practicando desde ahí para cuando ya nos toque irnos a las pequeñas secciones. Okay, what are we gonna do here? Ahorita que estamos todos acá, la voy a leer dos veces. I'm gonna read it twice para que escuchemos la pronunciación, okay? Y si tienen alguna duda en cuanto a alguna palabra, pues acá la podamos resolver antes de irnos a la práctica. Let's start first. La voy a leer una vez, ¿ok? La voy a leer. Si gustan, podemos practicar ahí con los micrófonos apagados. Luego de leerla, ustedes me dicen si tienen alguna duda en cuanto a alguna palabra de la conversación, ¿ok? O pronunciación de la conversación. Ok, let's start. This is a conversation between Janet and Cindy. And it says, good morning, Cindy. Listen, good morning, Cindy. How are you? How are you? And it says, Cindy, fine, fine. I have many things to do this week. I have many things to do this week. But Katie is very busy. But Katie is very busy. And it says, Janet, really? Listen, really? Who is Katie? Who is Katie? It says, Cindy, the new secretary. The new secretary. Her schedule, listen, her schedule is very tight. Her schedule is very tight. On Monday, she makes many phone calls. On Monday, she makes many phone calls. Later, she writes reports about the production. She writes reports about the production. And it says, Janet, and what does she do the other days? And what does she do the other days? And it says, Cindy, on Wednesday, she sends some emails. She sends some emails to the bookkeeper. To the bookkeeper. And on Friday, she arranges meetings. And on Friday, she arranges meetings. Okay. And it says, Janet, she is so busy. She is so busy. And on weekends. All right. Good. Do we have any questions related to this conversation? ¿Tenemos alguna duda en cuanto a vocabulario de esta conversación? I don't know about pronunciation.
Teacher.
Ajá.
Pronunciation. Bookkeeper.
Ah, yeah. Bookkeeper. That's the way. Bookkeeper. Okay.
Okay.
All right. Cool. Okay, Giovanni. Tell me.
Una vez donde empieza Cindy. Dice the new secretary y después dice her
schedule.
No le logro captar bien. No sé.
Okay. Listen up. Schedule. Schedule.
Schedule.
Yeah, schedule.
Schedule. Okay.
That's, that's the pronunciation. Schedule. Good. Any other questions related to this conversation? ¿Tienen alguna duda en cuanto a pronunciación de palabras o qué significa?
Bookkeeper. Teacher, bookkeeper.
Ok, bookkeeper viene siendo, en esta conversación en sí, viene siendo como contador. Okay, accountant. It's a synonym of accountant. Alguien que maneja las finanzas en una compañía. That's a bookkeeper. Okay.
¿Cómo se pronuncia esa palabra que acaba de mencionar?
Bookkeeper.
Teacher.
Ajá.
Las disculpas que acabo de ingresar, pero en el cuarto párrafo dice the new secretary her pronunciation.
Okay, okay. The pronunciation of that word is schedule. Schedule.
Schedule.
Yes, schedule.
¿Y español?
Schedule significa su agenda, su horario de trabajo, en that case.
Thank you, teacher.
All right. Welcome. Yes.
¿Qué significa tight?
Where is it? Ah, tight. Her schedule is very tight. Tight en este caso significa apretada, como cuando usted tiene muchas cosas que hacer. Ahí en ese caso, her schedule is very tight. Su, ¿cómo podría decir? Su agenda o su, sus actividades son like, ¿qué? Bien apretadas, como una después de la otra. Okay, todos por junto. That's tight.
Y busy.
Busy, ocupada. Ocupada o ocupado. Ajá. My work for both.
Ok.
Yeah, cool. Any other word that you probably do not understand from here?
Solo una aclaración, quiero estar seguro. Teacher, si es una pregunta, por ejemplo, cuando Janet contesta, and what does she do? En este caso, como es pregunta, no lleva el does. Ese tuya, solo en presente, en oraciones simples. Es cuando do se convierte en does.
Ok, usted habla del segundo do que está después de she.
Sí.
Ah, ese es el verbo principal. Recordémosle, okay. Recordemos que el does es nada más el auxiliar para saber si estamos hablando en tercera persona o en primera persona en presente simple. Luego, okay, el siguiente verbo después del sujeto es el verbo principal que indica acción. Y ahí okay, es no, el verbo do. Ajá.
Yo me refería al plural. Por ejemplo, cuando ella contesta, on Wednesday, she sends, ahí sí lleva una S, el sends, el verbo send.
Ah, ¿por qué? Sends.
Y en este otro, como, llevo, como es una pregunta, no lo ponemos en plural. Es así, para tener, para acordarme, creo.
Ah, ya, ya. En este caso, sí, va arriba en la pregunta, no hay ningún problema, porque ahí, como estamos hablando de días, pero en realidad ahí llevamos el does porque estamos hablando de ella, de las actividades que ella hace. No importa que las actividades estén en plural, pero como estamos hablando de ella, no hay ningún problema. Tenemos que colocar does, ¿ok? Luego abajo, a pesar de que dice on Wednesday, eso es un día típico, ¿ok? Los miércoles o el miércoles, luego está she. Como está she, ok, recordemos que ese es el indicativo del pronombre ella. Entonces, por obligación, si tenemos un verbo después de she, tiene que ir en tercera persona, ya con ese.
Thank you.
All right. She sends some emails to the bookkeeper. A pesar de que la palabra emails es plural, igual, no importa, porque ahí está describiendo la actividad o actividades que ella hace. Ok, entonces en este caso igual los verbos tienen que ir en tercera persona, ya con la modificación de la S, ES, dependiendo de la terminación del verbo. ¿Por qué? Porque antes de ese verbo, si ven, siempre va she. Okay, has to be like that. Very good. Any other question? ¿Alguna otra duda o pregunta? Ok, perfect. Now, what are we going to do with this? La voy a volver a pronunciar una vez más y luego la vamos a practicar, ¿ok? We're gonna practice this conversation in pairs. All right, let's pay attention to the pronunciation. Okay, it says, Janet, good morning, Cindy. How are you? Good morning, Cindy. How are you? Fine. I have many things to do this week. Fine. I have many things to do this week. But Katie is very busy. But Katie is very busy. Really? It says, really? Who is Katie? Who is Katie? And it says, Cindy, the new secretary. The new secretary. Her schedule is very tight. Is very tight. On Monday, she makes many phone calls. On Monday, she makes many phone calls. Later, she writes reports about the production. Later, she writes reports about the production. And then we got Janet. It says, what does she do the other days? What does she do the other days? And it says, Cindy, on Wednesday, she sends some emails to the bookkeeper. On Wednesday, she sends some emails to the bookkeeper. And on Friday, she arranges meetings. And on Friday, she arranges meetings. And it says, Janet, she is so busy. She is so busy. And on weekends? And on weekends? Very good. Now, what are we gonna do right now? I'm gonna stop sharing and we're gonna practice this conversation, okay, in pairs. Let me see. Okay, cool. Now, what I'm going to do, I am going to divide you, let me see, you are 18, bien, somos 18, vamos a hacer 8 mini grupos. Okay, let me see. Yeah, okay. 18. I'm going to assign you. Give me a second. Okay, give me a second. Second, I'm just sharing these things. Carlos Alberto is gonna work with him. Juan Carlos with Mela. Okay, good. What are we gonna do right now? Bien, entonces nos vamos a ir a pequeñas secciones en las cuales vamos a estar trabajando en parejitas. Y quiero que me practiquen esa conversación, ¿ok? Luego vamos a volver acá. And we're gonna give the practice, ¿ok? As we have been doing before. Good. Give us up to the request, please. Ok, bien. Démosle aceptar ahí y nos vamos a practicar la conversación. Carlos Eduardo, are you there? Okay, perfect.
On Monday, she makes me phone calls. Later, she writes report about the production. And what she do the other days? On Wednesdays, she sends some email to the bookkeeper. And on Friday, she arranged meeting.
Sorry. Her schedule is very tight. On Monday, she makes many phone calls. Later, she writes reports about.
And what does she do the other day?
Phil, who is Kathy?
The new secretary, her scaling is very time. On Monday, she makes money for gold. Later, she
right.
Report about the production. Production.
Yeah, production.
Huh? Production.
Yeah, production.
Okay, teacher.
Y Busy, lo que escribe Busy, ¿cómo se pronuncia?
Busy. Busy.
Busy. Busy. Yeah. Okay.
Busy.
Okay. And what does she do the other days?
On Wednesday, he said.
And what does she do the other days? Okay. On Wednesdays, she sends some email to the bookkeeper, and on Friday she arranged meeting.
She is busy and on weekend. Empezamos. Yo voy a hacer la primera porque a mí me cuesta más. Yo siempre cuesta menos.
Bye.
Bye, ok. Good morning. Cindy se dice, o cómo se decía, perdón.
Cindy.
Sí, ¿verdad? Sí.
Cindy.
Ok, Cindy. Good morning, Cindy. How are you? How are you, perdón.
How are you?
How are you?
Fine.
Sí, ¿verdad?
Yes. Fine. I have many things to do this week. But Katie is very busy.
Lily, who is Katie?
The new secretary here is Kate Duro. ¿Cómo se pronuncia, Tisha?
Schedule.
Yeah. Here, schedule is very tight.
Tight.
Her schedule is very tight. On Monday, she makes many phone calls late to report about the production.
What does she do day other day?
On Wednesday, she sends some emails to the bookkeeper, and on Friday, she arranges meetings.
She is too busy on weekends.
Ah, ok, bien, ahora alternense. Ella que haga la otra conversación y usted que viene la otra. Póngame a practicar más a Dania, ¿ok? Con la conversación larga.
Ok.
Yes. Go practice, Dania, you can, ¿ok?
Ok. Good morning, Cindy. How are you?
Hi.
Hola, teacher.
Hello. Okay, acabo de entrar. Ajá, ajá. Tell me.
Una pregunta. Mi question.
Tell me.
En la última parte donde dice Cindy, dice, bueno, así vea, a palabra de español, arranje, vea. O sea, ¿cómo se pronuncia en inglés?
Ah, arranges.
Arrange.
Ajá. No, ¿cómo es?
Vaya, cuando no está la... Ok, let me see. Listen. Cuando no está la S, es arrange. Arrange. Cuando ya le agregamos la S, es arranges. Arranges.
Es como decir arrange, arranges.
Ajá.
Como...
Ya, solo que se le escucha como I. Tiene que ser con E. Arranges.
Arranges.
Yes.
Arranges. Ah, yeah. Es que en esa palabra estábamos.
Arrangers. Arrangers.
Arranges.
Arranges. Arrange. Arrange.
Pero con Y, profe.
Yes.
Arrangers. Arrangers.
Ranges, ajá.
Okay.
Ah, okay, very good. Okay. Continue practice.
Okay. Y la otra.
Ajá.
Okay.
¿Cuál otra?
Y la otra que tenía, bueno, que ten, yo también tengo la duda, es en meeting. ¿Cómo es la pronunciación? Meetings.
Meetings.
La que le sigue.
Ah, ¿cómo? Meetings. Meetings.
Meetings.
La,
okay.
La T se convierte en R. Meetings.
Meetings.
Yeah, meetings.
Meetings.
Okay.
Pues.
Okay. Continue practicing.
O sea que sería arranger meetings.
Arranges meetings. Yes.
Okay.
Meet. Okay. No sé si empieza o empiezo yo.
Ahí organícense como ustedes gusten, ¿ok?
Ok.
Practíquenme, entonces, luego vamos a continuar, ¿ok? Voy a revisar con okay, otras parejas. Ok, bye bye.
Ok.
Some emails to the bookkeeper on Friday. She arranges meeting.
She is so busy, and on a weekend,
busy.
She is so busy.
Ahí donde tenemos, escrito que está busy, es busy. La U se convierte en I en pronunciación. Busy, ¿ok?
Busy.
Yeah, busy.
Ok.
Yo pensé que era así como cuando pronunciamos la palabra bush.
Ah, no. That case has to
bush.
Be
that.
Yes. Yes, has to be B.
Okay. Teacher, ¿cómo se pronuncia la palabra schedule o schedule?
Schedule. Schedule.
Schedule.
Yes, that's the word.
Okay.
Schedule.
Schedule.
Yeah.
Schedule.
Yeah, very good. Let's keep going.
Vaya, comienzo. Juan.
Dale, dale.
Juan. Sí, Juan. Good morning, Cindy. How are you?
Fine. I have many things to do this week, but Katie is very busy.
Create yes no questions using the words in parentheses. Write the answer. Do you work in the company? Yes. Do they check the product?
Raro.
No, they doesn't.
What happened there? Is something weird? Are you all right?
No. That is okay.
Ah, okay, cool.
Okay,
okay, perfect. Bien, entonces.
You're practicing the conversation.
All right, perfect. Voy a revisar otro grupito entonces. Cool. Let's see. What are you guys doing? What happened with the practice, guys? Did you finish?
Yes, finish.
Really? That was easy. Nice. Very good. So I hope you're ready. Espero estén listos entonces. Good. Solo voy a revisar el último y volvemos a la sala principal.
Bueno.
Okay, very good.
She is so busy. Son correctas, solo que una va contractada y la otra va este de una.
You know, weekends. Okay. Bueno. Good morning, Cindy. How are you?
Fine. I have many things to do this week, but Katie is very busy.
Really? Who is Katie?
The new secretary. Her schedule is very on Monday. She makes many phone calls. Later, she writes reports about the production.
And what does she do the other days?
On Wednesday.
Espérame, es una pregunta. And what does she do the other days?
On Wednesday, she sends some emails to the bookkeeper. And on Friday, she arranges meetings.
She is so busy. And on weekends?
It's busy.
She is so busy.
Yeah.
Ah, que es la misma del principio. Sí, es cierto, tienes razón.
Okay, voy.
She is so busy.
Yeah. Good morning, Cindy. How are you?
Fine. I have many things to do this week. Bukate is very busy.
Really? Who is Katie?
The new secretary. Her schedule is very thick. On Monday, she makes many phone calls. Later, she writes report about the production.
And what does she do the other days?
Wednesday, she sends some emails to the bookkeeper, and on Friday, she arranged meetings.
And on Friday, Friday.
And on Friday, and on Friday, mm-hmm. she arranged meeting.
She is so busy. Yeah, she's so busy, and on weekends.
Okay, esa última que parezca pregunta. And on weekends, okay.
Okay. And on weekends.
Yeah, there you go. Very good.
Teacher, teacher, Friday, ¿puedo decirlo Friday o Friday?
Friday.
Friday. Okay.
Yes. Yeah, because it's a day of the week. Friday.
Friday.
Yes.
And on Very weekends. Good. Okay.
Very good. So, yeah. Ahora sí, vámonos a la sesión principal. Vamos a practicar, ¿ok? All right, okay. Let's go back. Okay, so we are back to the main section. Turn on your cameras. I want to see your very, very nice faces. Okay, cool. Nice. All right. One is missing, right? Okay, two are missing. Bueno, si me salieron dos, no me han vuelto. Okay. I guess they're coming back in the meantime. All right, good. Antes de comenzar la práctica, because I want to see how much you have practiced, I'm going to pass attendance list. Voy a pasar asistencia, and then we can continue with the practice, okay? Because it's basically time. Carla Lisette?
Present.
All right, thank you. Carlos Eduardo?
Present.
Thank you. Carlos Gualberto?
Present.
Thank you. Dalila Abigail, no here. Dania Rebeca.
Present.
Thank you. Eric Jonathan.
Present.
Thank you, Mr. Giovanni Pineda.
Present.
Thank you. Alexander Ramirez.
Present.
Thank you. Juan Carlos Palacios.
Present.
Thank you. Juan Carlos Peña.
I'm here.
Thank you. Juan Osmel.
Present.
Thank you. Kevin Antonio.
Present.
Thank you. Marlon Alberto.
Present.
Okay, thank you. Miguel Ángel.
Present.
Thank you. Nancy Yvette.
Present.
Okay, thank you. Omar Alfredo.
Present, teacher.
All right, thank you. Silvia Zuleima.
Present.
Okay, good. Zuleima Veronica.
Present.
Okay, thank you. And Walter Daniel.
Present, teacher.
Okay, thank you. Very good. So let's start. Let's start with the practice. Let's start with the practice. Walter, who do you work with?
Who is Juan? Juan.
Isn't it Juan Osmel?
Juan Osmel.
Ah, okay, very good.
Juan Osmel.
Very good. I want to listen to you both, okay? Can you start? Good. Quiero escucharlos a ustedes primero. Do it.
Okay. We are ready.
Juan, ¿podría repetirlo porque no se le escuchó?
I start.
Okay, do it.
Ahora sí ya me escuchan.
Yes.
Okay. I start.
Okay, do it.
Good morning, Cindy. How are you?
Espérame que se me perdió. Ahorita.
Page 21. Okay, let me see.
Okay.
I'm gonna put it in
Repeat, please.
There you go. Walter, se lo voy a poner en pantalla para que no le cueste.
Okay.
Good morning, Cindy. How are you?
Fine. I have many things to this week, to do this week, but Katie is very busy, very busy.
Really? Who is Katie? Pardon, who is Katie?
The new secretary, her schedule is very, very tight on Monday. She makes many phone calls, letters. She writes reports about the production.
And what does she do the other days?
On Wednesday, she sends some emails to the bookkeeper, and on Friday, she arranges meeting.
She is so busy, and on weekends?
Okay, very good. Perfect, Walter and Juan. Thank you to you both. You did it good. Juan Carlos Palacios, who do you work with?
Okay. Lo hicimos con Zuleima Melgar.
Okay, good. Let's practice.
Zuleima.
Okay. Good morning, Cindy. How are you?
Fine. I have many things to do this week, but Katie is very busy.
Mm-hmm. Really? Is who Katie?
Who is Katie? Who is Katie?
Hi. Who is Katie?
Okay.
The new secretary, her schedule is very tight. On Monday, she makes many work.
She makes many phone calls. She writes the report about the pollution.
What does she do other days?
On Wednesday, she sends some emails to the bookkeeper, and on Friday, she arranges meetings.
She is so busy, and on the weekends.
Okay, and on the weekends. Very good, Suleyma. Thank you, Juan Carlos.
Good. Thank you, Juan Carlos.
Silvia, who do you work with?
With Carla Orellana.
Very good. Let's practice.
Good morning, Cindy. How are you?
Fine. I have many things to do this week, but Katie is very busy.
Really? How is Katie?
The new secretary. Her schedule is very tight. On Monday, she makes many phone calls. Later, she writes reports about the production.
And that does she do the other days?
On Wednesdays, she sends some emails to the bookkeepers, and on Friday, she arranges meetings.
She is so busy, and Weekend.
Weekends. Okay, very good. Thank you, Silvia. Thank you, Carla. Very good. Omar, your turn, mister. Who do you work with?
Giovanni Alexander.
Okay, good. Let's practice.
Okay, good morning, Cindy. How are you?
Fine. I have many things this week.
To do?
Katie is very busy.
Really? Who is Katie?
The new secretary. Her schedule is very tight. On Monday, she makes many phone calls. Later, she writes report about the production.
And what does she do the other day?
On Wednesday, she sent some email to the bookkeeper, and on Friday, she arranged meeting.
She's so busy, and on weekends?
Okay, very good. Thank you, Giovanni. Thank you, Omar.
Okay.
Very good.
Welcome.
Let's see. Miguel, your turn. Who do you work with?
Okay. Okay, vamos, Juan Carlos.
Okay.
Good morning, Cindy. How are you?
Fine. I have many things to do this week, but Katie is very busy.
Really? Who is Katie?
The new secretary. Her schedule is very thin. On Monday, she makes many phone calls. Later, she writes reports about the production.
And what does she do the other days?
On Wednesday, she sends some emails to the bookkeeper. And on Friday, she arranges meetings.
He is so busy. And on weekends?
Okay, very good. Thank you, Mr. Thank you, Miguel, and thank you, Juan Carlos. Let's see. Okay, Carlos Gualberto. Who did you work with?
Kevin.
Okay.
With Kevin.
Good morning, Cindy. How are you?
Fine. I have many things to do this week, but Katie is very busy.
Really? Who is Katie?
The new secretary. Her schedule is very tight. On Monday, she makes many phone calls. Later, she writes reports about the production.
What does she do the other days?
On Wednesday, she sends some emails to the bookkeeper, and on Friday, she arranges meetings.
She is so busy. On weekends?
Okay, she's so busy. And on weekends? Okay, remember the word busy.
Okay,
very good, Kevin. And thank you, Carlos. Very good. Let's see who's missing. Alexander Ramirez. And if I'm not mistaken, it's with Daniel, right?
Daniel.
Okay.
You start, Daniel.
Good morning. Good morning, Cindy. How are you?
Fine. I have many things to do this week, but Katie is very busy.
Really? Who is Katie?
The new secretary. Her schedule is very tight. On Monday, she makes many phone calls. Later, she writes report about the production.
And what does she do the other day?
On Wednesdays, she sends some emails to the bookkeeper, and on Friday she arranged meetings.
He is too busy and on weekends.
Okay, very good. Thank you, Dania. Aunque pensé que iba a decir la más larga. Nah, I'm kidding. And thank you, Giovanni. All right, let's see, Nancy. Do you work with Nancy?
Hello, con Eric Mena.
Very good. Let's start practicing.
Okay. Good morning, Cindy. Let's go.
Usted comience, Nancy.
Okay. Good morning, Cindy. How are you?
Fine, I am many. Perdón, hi. How many is to do the whip? Katy is very busy.
Really? How is Katy?
The new secretary, Chair Chundulay, is very keen on Monday. She's making money from car. Later, she's great report about a book.
About
the production.
And what doesn't she do the other day?
On Wednesday, she sent some emails to the bookkeeper, and of free day, she's arrived, married.
Okay, and on Fridays, she arranged.
And on Friday, she arranged. Yeah.
Meetings.
Very good,
Eddie.
Okay, she is so busy and on weekends.
Okay, good question. Very good. Thank you, Nancy, and thank you, Eric. You did it good. Let's see who's missing, who got missing part. Marlon. I don't know if I'm wrong, but have you practiced? All right.
Yes, with Carlos Maldonado.
Ah, you were with Carlos. Okay. You already practiced, right?
Yeah.
Okay, cool. Because I didn't remember. So basically, who has not participated? I think everybody has participated, right? Bien, ya todos participamos entonces. That's cool.
Nosotros todavía no hemos participado.
Ah, yeah, that's what Marlo. I'm asking. That's what I'm asking. Okay, por eso estaba preguntando. And I was like, sí, ya participado. Okay. No, entonces me
quedo. Okay, Marlo, si gusta, yo comienzo.
Okay, do it.
Okay.
Okay, good morning, Cindy. How are you?
Fine. I have many things to do this week, but Katie is very busy.
Really? Who is Katie?
The new secretary. Her schedule is very tight. On Monday, she makes many phone calls. Later, she writes reports about the production.
And what does she do the other days?
On Wednesday, she sends some emails to the bookkeeper. And on Friday, she arranged a meeting.
She is so busy. And no weekends?
Okay. So busy. Nobody knows. Okay. And on weekends? There you go. Very good. Now, this is a way how we can be practicing in this couple of days that are missing from this module. You're going to practice in conversations like this. It's going to be very useful. Okay, cool. Apartemos lo de la conversación, and then we are going to introduce new daily routines vocabulary, okay? So we're gonna start again with daily routines. Okay, from the ones that we generally do. Okay, this is the routine that we generally do. The first one, listen up, is hang the clothes. Recordemos, y aquí vamos a introducir vocabulario. Hang the clothes. That's the pronunciation of that. Hang the clothes. Iron the clothes. Okay. Iron the clothes. Then we got make the bed. Make the bed. Cualquiera puede decir, pero make significa fabricar. ¿Qué tiene que ver con cama? ¿Fabricar una cama? No. Esta es una expresión. This is an expression y significa like ordenar la cama. Okay? O literal, hacer la cama. Cama. Exactly. There you go. Then we got go to bed or go to bed. If you want to do it like that, like important. Go to bed. Wake up. Okay, the ones that we were practicing yesterday. Wake up. Brush the teeth. Okay, like cepillar los dientes. Brush the teeth. Remember that one?
Teacher.
Yes.
Una consulta. Bueno, que a mí me cuesta pronunciar el vocabulario. ¿Cómo puede ser la, bueno, lo más fácil para poderse adaptar a hacer las pronunciaciones? ¿Qué uno tiene que hacer para poderse adaptar?
Good.
¿O cuál es la técnica?
En este caso, la única técnica viable es la repetición. Repeat the words. Repetir las palabras, ¿ok? Repetirlas. Solo como a modo de consejo, no tratemos de memorizar la pronunciación o, por así decirlo, no más de 8 a 10 palabras. ¿Okay? ¿Por qué? Porque si tratamos de memorizarnos el montón de palabras de una vez, al final de cuentas, para el día de mañana, probablemente una sea la que se acuerde y de las demás no tanto. Entonces, mi consejo es que de este tipo de vocabulario es así, practiquemos la pronunciación bastante, like, seguido. That's the only key that you have to learn the pronunciation of this one. Eso sería practicar más que todo, la práctica, la repetición.
Okay, gracias.
All right, you got brush the teeth. Okay, remember, brush the teeth, like cepillar los dientes. Drive to work. Drive to work. An example using drive to work. So I can say, give me a second, I'm going to put the chat in here.
Ahí no sería drive.
No, in here is drive. ¿Por qué? Porque generalmente cuando usted va al trabajo, si va en su carro, va a conducir. So, drive to work is like manejar al trabajo, conducir al trabajo. Okay, entonces usted puede decir, I drive my car to work. So, you easily have a positive statement there. Entonces ahí tenemos una oración positiva en presente simple relacionada a qué? A las daily activities, a la actividad que yo diariamente hago. Si es en tercera persona, she drives to, I mean, she drives her car to work. Para ser bien específico. She drives her car to work. You see? There you go. Very good. Let's continue. Get home. Listen up. Get home. Get home significa llegar a casa, ¿ok? Cuando generalmente ya vamos del trabajo y pues estamos a punto de llegar a la casa o cuando llegamos. Ahí es get home, llegar a casa, ¿ok? Get home. All right, cool. So this is part of the vocabulary that we have for right now. Let me see. Brush your hair. Listen, brush your hair. That's the pronunciation of this one, okay? It's like peinarse. That's all it wants to give the translation, okay? Brush your hair like peinarse, peinar tu cabello. That's the way. Then we got surf the net. Navegar en la red o navegar en internet. Surf the net, okay? Net es un indicativo de internet. So that's the way how we work. Wash the car. This is another one, okay? Wash the car. Like lavar el carro. Esta puede estar incluida entre las actividades que nosotros generalmente hacemos. Get dressed. Okay? Get dressed. Does anybody know what is get dressed? ¿Alguien sabe qué significa esta expresión? Get dressed.
Vestirse.
Exactly. Vestirse. Get dressed significa vestirse. Go out with a friend. Go out with a friend. Like salir con un amigo o amiga, as you want to say, okay? Go out with a friend. Take pictures. Take pictures. This is another one, okay? Take pictures. What is that about? Okay, take pictures, like tomar fotografías, okay? That's what it means. Play the guitar, all right? So we got play the guitar. So that's another one. You know what is to play the guitar. And we got the last one, water the plants. En este caso, la palabra water, okay, a pesar de que es un nombre y lo conocemos como agua, aquí está actuando como un verbo, okay? Water significa regar. Listen up, regar. Water the plants, regar las plantas, okay? So I can give you an example of it. The gardener, let me see. The gardener waters the plant. Give me a second, I'm gonna. There you go. Ahí les acabo de mandar un ejemplo al chat. The gardener waters the plants. El jardinero riega las plantas. So you see? The gardener, okay, waters the plant. And then we have the last one, and it says, go for a walk. Okay? Ir a dar un paseo, por así decirlo. That's the translation of that. Okay? Ir a un paseo. Okay? Go for a walk. Remember that, okay? Go for a walk. Good. De este vocabulario que tenemos acá, ¿tenemos alguna pregunta? Any question? Might be related to pronunciation, it might be related to translation. ¿Tenemos alguna duda con relación a este vocabulario?
Solo una pregunta, teacher.
Yeah, tell me.
Ride to work, si voy en motocicleta, ¿funciona? Ride? Ah,
ya no sería drive, sería ride.
Okay.
Yeah, the verb ride. Very good. Any other question, alguna otra pregunta? Very nice. Let's continue. And now, what do I want with this? We are going to do this practice later on. Give me a second. These are the general questions that we ask to those people that we want to know their daily routines. Básicamente, cuando queremos preguntar sobre un día específico, ¿qué has hecho durante un día específico? Las actividades. Decimos, what do you do every Saturday? Ahí, ¿qué haces cada sábado? Yo la puedo modificar ahí. What do you do every Monday? What do you do every Saturday? Okay. What do you do every Thursday? Entonces ahí somos, how to say this? Tenemos la opción de escoger cualquier día de la semana y colocarla en esa pregunta. Okay. And that's it. Example of it. I go to the movie theater with my family. Ahí tenemos un ejemplo claro de cómo dar respuesta a esa pregunta. What do you do every Saturday? I go to the movie theater with my family. What is movie theater? ¿Recordamos esa frase? I think we have discussed that phrase. ¿Qué significa movie theater? Hello.
¿Función de teatro?
No.
¿Película?
Ver películas con la familia.
¿Cómo se llama el lugar donde generalmente suelen ir a ver películas?
Ir al cine con la familia.
Yes, yes. Movie theater significa cine. Ok. Solo theater significa teatro. Ok, remember that. Only theater means teatro. But movie theater es una frase compuesta y ahí significa cine. Okay, remember that. Another one, I cook the dinner. You see, I cook the dinner. I play tennis with my friends. Listen up. I play tennis with my friends. So those are possible answers to the main question. Entonces, básicamente son respuestas, ok, en lista de qué se puede hacer un sábado o cada sábado. Ok, those are the daily activities that we're gonna be like practicing. Very good. Now, let's continue. Si no tenemos ninguna pregunta, vamos a continuar. Good. Eso eran todo con relación a something personal, algo personal, ¿ok? Con relación a las actividades que nosotros generalmente hacemos. Ahora bien, acá vamos a describir a una tercera persona. It says, what does your friend do on weekends? ¿Qué hace tu amigo o tu amiga los fines de semana? Easy. Carla, help me a reading, please. Léame, Carla, por favor.
She walks her dog.
Okay, she walks her dog. Ella saca a pasear a su perro. There you go. That's the way how it works. Walter, read the second one, please.
She takes care of her cousin.
Okay, thank you. She takes care of her cousin. Like, ella cuida a su sobrino, a primo o prima, might be. Remember, cousin means primo or prima. Carlos Gualberto, read the next one.
She cooks the breakfast.
Okay, very good. She cooks the breakfast. Carlos Eduardo.
She watches TV.
Okay. She watches TV. Like, ella ve televisión. I was like getting up. Good. Next one, Juan Carlos.
She washes her clothes.
Okay, thank you. She washes her clothes. That's the way how it works. Very good. I don't know if you're taking notes about this. No sé si están tomando nota de ello. Okay, si no, si es así, no lo paso todavía. But let me know if you're
talking. Finish.
Okay, very good. Thank you, Carlos.
Finished.
Okay, very good. Thank you.
teacher, ¿qué significa la última oración? She wasn't here close.
Ella lava, ella lava su ropa. That's the meaning.
Okay.
She washes her clothes. Thank you. Ella lava su ropa. You're welcome.
Okay.
Okay. Very good. I guess you have already finished this thing. Now, what are we gonna do? Listen up. Now we are going to do it not in pairs, because in pairs we have been working before. But I want, listen up, listen up. Vamos a comenzar con las terceras personas. Listen, quiero que escojan un miembro de su familia o un compañero de trabajo que ustedes tengan. Okay, whatever, it's up to you. Y quiero que describan a esa persona qué es lo que hace. What does this person do during the day? Ok. Descríbanme a esa persona. Si es un miembro de su familia, perfect. Vamos a escribir ahí quién es, like, my brother's daily routine. Y luego comienzan ustedes. Ok, with this. What do I really want? Quiero que me incluyan. ¿Qué? This. Esto es lo que quiero que me incluyan. Part of this vocabulary. Entonces, quiero que me incluyan en esas actividades que van a mencionar, este vocabulario, parte de este vocabulario. Okay? How many sentences do I want? Quiero cuatro oraciones nada más. Cuatro actividades from that person. Let me know when you finish, please. Just let me know when you finish. Remember, the activities can be from this vocabulary. Las actividades que les estoy pidiendo, las oraciones que les estoy pidiendo pueden ser tomadas de ese vocabulario que está ahí, el que aparece en su pantalla. Let me know when you finish. Si tienen alguna duda, me lo hacen saber, please. So we can solve. Just let me know when you finish. Four.
Four.
Yeah, just four sentences.
I finished.
Okay, very good.
Finish.
Okay, very good. All right, mientras los demás terminan, Juan, can you please start?
Finish.
Okay, very good, Carlos. Good, Juan. Quiero que me lea las oraciones que tiene.
Yes. I talk to you about my wife.
Ah, okay.
My wife wakes up at 6 a.m.
Very good.
Brush her teeth.
Okay.
She helps to water the plants.
Ah, okay, very good.
She cooks the breakfast.
Excellent. Excellent, Juan, thank you. Let's okay. See, who was the other one who told me, what was the girl that told me the finish? Silvia, it was you?
Okay. What does Mary do on your day? She wakes up. She brushes your hair. She goes out.
Silvia, in that case, como estamos hablando de una mujer, una tercera persona, ahí ya no sería your her, sería her, her.
Okay. She brushes her hair.
Brushes her hair. Ahí el verbo brush ya llevaría la E y la S. Brushes.
Correcto. She goes out her friends.
With her friends. Okay, very good.
She takes pictures.
Okay, very good. She takes pictures. Thank you, Silvia. Silvia, do me a favor. Quiero que escoja uno de sus compañeros, Silvia, to be the next.
Nancy?
All right, Nancy. You ready?
Okay. My sister is Damaris.
Ah, okay.
Week 7. No sé si está bien. She like play the guitar. She take picture y surf the, bueno, she surf the net.
Okay, she surf the net. Right, very good. Thank you, Nancy. Nancy, okay. Choose one of your classmates.
And
el primero que aparezca ahí, Nancy.
Walter González.
Very good.
Okay.
Thank you, Nancy.
What does your friend do a week? Do you Saturdays?
Okay.
He drives to work at 5 a.m.
Okay.
He surfs the net at 6 a.m.
Very good.
He plays guitar after work.
All right, very good. Plays the guitar after work. Okay, good.
After work.
Thank you, Walter. Very good. Choose one of your classmates. Choose one of your classmates.
Nancy Tovar.
She participated already. Ella la eligió a usted, así que ella participó. Another one.
Okay.
Okay. Venganza instantánea era esa. Okay.
Marlon Cardona.
Okay, very good.
Okay. It's about my father.
Okay, very good.
He gets up at 5 a.m.
Okay.
And then he makes the bed 15 minutes later. Well, then he washed the car at 6 a.m.
Ah, okay. Uh-huh. He washed then the car at 6 a.m.
Yes. Yeah.
Okay.
He drives to the work at 7 a.m.
He drives to work at 7 a.m. Okay, very good. Thank you, Marlon. Choose one of your classmates, Marlon, the ones that are not participated.
Carla.
All right, Carla. Where is Carla? Ah, yeah, yeah. She's there.
Mama. My daughter is routine.
Ah, okay.
She wakes at 5 a.m.
Okay.
She makes the bed. She goes to work. She gets home at 8 p.m.
Ah, she wakes up. Okay, very good. Okay. All right, good. I know you're done. Nice. Let's see. I'm going to choose for you, Carla, because I think you're kind of busy. Juan Carlos, read your activities, please.
Talk about my dad.
Uh-huh.
Okay. My father wake up at 5 o'clock.
Okay.
He drives his car to work.
Very good.
And he washes his car on Sunday.
Very good.
He gets home at 7 o'clock.
Okay, at 7 o'clock. Okay, very good. Thank you, Juan Carlos. Choose another one. Choose another one to read the examples.
Suleyma.
Very good. Thank you. Suleyma, read your activities. Or your friend's activities, actually.
Bueno, my mother really... She makes, no, she wakes up at 5 a.m.
Ah, wakes up, okay.
She cooks the lunch.
She cooks the lunch, very good.
She waters the plant.
Okay, very good.
She makes the bed.
She makes the bed.
O la S al final, ¿verdad?
Ajá. Makes. Okay, very good.
Thank you.
Okay, thank you, Suleyma. Let's see, Dania, your turn.
My sister get up. 5 a.m.
Okay.
She takes a breakfast at 6 a.m. She works until 8 a.m. She gets dressed at 7:50 a.m.
Okay, very good. Thank you, Dania. Let's see, Alexander. I think you haven't participated.
My routine. She goes to work 5 a.m.
Very good.
She gets up and brushes the teeth.
Very good.
She brushes your hair later shower.
Hair. Yes.
Later shower. And she goes away and a friend to the beach.
Ah, okay. I didn't listen that one. But I think it's okay. Thank you, Alexander. There you go. Who's missing? Let's see. Mm-hmm. Omar, did you do yours?
Okay. Wake up at 6 a.m. She drives to work.
Uh-huh.
She watches TV. She goes to bed.
And she goes to bed.
Goes to bed. Huh?
Ah, that's the last one. Goes to bed. Okay, very good. Thank you, Mark. Giovanni. think you haven't participated.
Okay. My wife, she wakes up early and she takes shower at 7 a.m. She cooks the breakfast. Later, she works in her business.
Okay, very good. She works in her business. Thank you, Giovanni. Very good. Eric, are you there?
Hola, profe. No sé si están bien, but my father drives to work. My father goes for a while. She plays the guitar. The guitar.
Ah, she plays the guitar. Okay.
Mm-hmm.
Okay, let's try to do the other one, Eric. Okay. Good. Let's try to do the other one. Let's see who's missing. Miguel, did you participate already?
Daily routine, my son.
Okay, your son.
She wakes up at 6 a.m. She had dressed at 6:10 a.m. She washed the car and she played the guitar at lunch.
Okay, she washes the car and she plays the guitar at home. Okay, thank you. Thank you, Miguel.
Okay.
Okay. Solo una pequeña observación, Miguel. Usted dijo my son, right?
No, daily routine, my son.
Ahí le vamos a poner, en vez de my son, my daughter.
Ahí my daughter. Ah, oh, okay.
Este es hija. Son es hijo. Okay. Very good. Very good. Let's see who's missing. Okay, who has not participated? Carlos Eduardo, right? Okay, good.
Okay. Okay. Daily routine, my daughter Katie.
Okay.
Okay. She take picture with your cell phone.
Give me a second, Carlos. Repeat the question. I mean the sentence.
She takes picture with your cell phone.
With her cell phone.
Her cell phone. Her cell phone. Okay. She takes picture with your her cell phone.
El your.
Okay, picture. Second.
El your elimination. Sure.
Okay. She takes picture with her cell phone.
Very good.
Okay. She brushes your hair. She wakes. No, she wakes up very early.
Wakes up.
She makes the bed every day.
Okay, she makes the bed every day. Good. Very nice. Carlos Gualberto, did you read yours?
Pato.
Okay, very good. Yeah, you're the one.
My daughter, daily routine.
Very good.
She wakes up at 6 a.m. She takes a shower. She brushes her teeth. She takes breakfast. She goes to her class.
Okay, she goes to her class. Okay, very good. Thank you, Carlos. Very nice. Now, what are we going to do with this information? Look, after the short practice that we have been doing, después de la práctica un tanto corta, okay, what are we going to do? Let's go to the manual.
No participo.
Yo falto. Hola.
Oh, my God. Seriously? Okay, I'm my mistake. Good. First, Juan Carlos and then Kevin. Thank you. Thank you for reminds me. Es que siempre se me mueven las benditas cuadrículas. And I last track.
Daily routines, my wife.
Ah, okay, your wife.
She irons the clothes.
Ah, okay, very good.
She takes care of the gears. All she right. Surfs the net.
She surfs the net, okay.
She makes the bill.
She, the last one, I didn't listen that much.
She makes the bed.
Ah, she makes the bed.
Makes the bed.
Okay, very good. Thank you, Juan Carlos. And I'm sorry about having you apart. Okay, Kevin.
Okay. My brother George's routines.
All right.
He cooks the breakfast at 7 a.m. He brushes the things and 7:30. He studies our morning. He plays soccer in the afternoon.
Ah, okay, very good. In the morning and then in the afternoon. Okay, very good. Thank you, Kevin. And I'm sorry about not putting you in the list. Okay, cool. Now, what are we going to do? I'm going to stop sharing this screen. Voy a dejar de compartir pantalla y vamos a trabajar en estos 8 minutos en el manual. Okay? The activities that appears in the manual. So take out the manuals. So give me a second, I'm gonna share this. Okay, cool. So in here you got the manual. And we are going to be working on, okay, this is the activity that we have. Give me a second. Okay, if you remember, this is the third person, okay, of singular. This one. Entonces, básicamente aquí tenemos las terceras personas de los del singular. Affirmative and negative statements. Just to be clear. Terminamos esto la clase la vez pasada que comenzamos el ejercicio o we didn't finish. Confírmenme por favor. We didn't do this exercise, right?
No lo terminamos, teacher.
Very good. We didn't finish. Now what are we going to do like right now? We are going to finish it, okay? Vamos a terminarlo entonces. It says. Si ven, ahí tenemos un verbo en paréntesis para complementar.
Disculpe, teacher, ¿qué, la oración. ¿Qué página es?
Ok, this is the page
22.
Yeah, 22. Page 22. Yeah. Good, we had it in here. Tenemos un verbo en paréntesis. What are we going to do in there? Entonces, como las oraciones están en tercera persona y algunas de ellas en plurales, vamos a colocar la forma correcta del verbo, ya sea con S, ES o IES, dependiendo del tipo de verbo que tengamos ahí, ¿ok? We got the first one. Hagamos la primera. Dice, he, and then in parentheses, got the order. And then it says, everything in the office. Bien, entonces ahí vamos a colocar el verbo allá afuera, en la pequeña línea y decimos he orders, ya el verbo order con S. He orders everything in the office. Okay. He orders everything in the office. So we got the verb with the S. Now let's do number two, number three, number four, and number five and six. Acá tenemos uno y acá tenemos también uno. Don't pay attention to this, ¿ok? No prestemos atención a esas. Tenemos algunas que tenemos como, por ejemplo, estas. Que tenemos not call, ¿ok? Not call. ¿Cuál es el auxiliar? Ok, Juan. ¿Cuál es el auxiliar que utilizamos con not para hacer oraciones en negativas en tercera persona?
Doesn't.
Exactly, okay, ahí ya sería unido, doesn't. Y el verbo, recordemos, tiene que ir en forma base, okay? So what are we going to do with that in here? Entonces quedaría más o menos así. Let me see. Helen doesn't, I think it's called. Helen doesn't call the design department on weekend. So you see, in that case, this is the example. Let me know when you finish. Okay, who finished? Ah, okay, Juan Carlos. Good, Juan Carlos. Can you please read number two for me?
Number two.
Yeah, number two.
I'm interested as for the signature every Friday.
Good. Ask. Sin ese, right?
Sin ese.
Very good. Yeah, that's
it's
the way.
Plural.
Because it's plural. Very good. Yeah. Because it's plural. Carlos Gualberto, can you please read number, let me see, because number three, I already did it. Number four.
She cleans our desk in the morning.
Cleans. Okay.
Cleans.
Very good. Yeah, cleans. Okay, entonces el verbo clean ahí lleva la S. Very good. Thank you, mister. She cleans our desks in the morning. Very good. Nancy, I want you to read this one. Déjame eso, por favor.
Okay. ¿Cuál teacher? Perdón que me perdí.
La que está en, sombreada.
Ah. I write an instant with the time.
The things
we need. Need at 9 a.m. No sé cómo se dice a.m.
A.m. Ah, okay, very good. A.m.
A.m.
Very good. Thank you, Suleyma. Read the next one.
Mario. Mario does keep a record of the merchandise. He buys.
La palabra buy, ¿cómo tiene que ir ahí?
Buys. Buys.
Okay, okay. Let's repeat it once again. Okay, once again. It says, Mario doesn't keep.
Keep a record.
Okay, doesn't keep a record.
Of
the merchandise,
he,
okay, después de he, ¿qué va a ser, Leima?
Buys.
El verbo buy, solo que el verbo buy ya lleva la S, buys. Okay, a record of the merchandise he buys. Okay, Suleyma. All right, very good. Thank you. Good, people. Look, because of the time, we're going to stay out here. All right. Por motivos de tiempo, pues nos vamos a quedar hasta acá. We're going to stop the practice. Give me a second. I'm going to stop sharing. And we're going to continue tomorrow. Para mañana vamos a tener igual una práctica de una conversación. Y vamos a terminar los otros ejercicios del manual. Y con eso ya daríamos finalización a la segunda semana. Remember, como recordatorio antes de que nos vayamos. Para mañana está el midterm, ¿ok? Durante el día lo pueden hacer, el examen de medio curso. Remember, está en la segunda sección donde están haciendo las tareas, ¿ok? Donde cuando se metan a esa sección ahí, que les aparecería como sección 1, ¿ok? Section 1, que sería la semana pasada, then section 2, luego en la sección 2, ahí les aparece daily routines y entre paréntesis 5 preguntas. Abajo de ello les aparece midterm, ¿ok? Midterm, y aparece 4 preguntas. En realidad son 4 secciones, ¿ok? Good. Entonces, para mañana, please try to do it, ¿ok? Entonces quedaría el examen de medio nivel and also remember that the homeworks. Para los que no lo han hecho, las tareas también en la plataforma, ¿ok? Please try to do it. Tratémoslas de hacer, por favor, ¿ok? Good. Si no las tenemos completas, pues mañana ya estarían completas. Ok, cool. Before we go, ¿tenemos alguna duda? ¿Alguna pregunta con la práctica del día de hoy? Or any topic that you want?
En el último ejemplo que dio, ahí donde decía vice, solo se le agrega S, no aplicaría la regla y normal ES.
Bien, perfecto. Buena pregunta. No, no se le agregaría la IES. ¿Por qué? A ver, ¿hay alguien que me pueda explicar el por qué?
Porque va precedida por una vocal.
Ah, ok. Thank you, Juan Carlos. Yes. Bien, entonces, en ese verbo, Juan Carlos, listen up. No colocamos IES, ok. No eliminamos la Y porque antes de la Y va una vocal. Y cuando es así, el verbo simplemente le agregamos una S. ¿Ok? Por ejemplo, el verbo play. Termina en Y, pero antes de la Y va la A. Entonces se le agrega S. She plays soccer. ¿Ok? Entonces, ¿cuándo se le modifica la Y y se le coloca I normal y luego ES? Cuando va, termina el verbo en Y, pero antes de la Y va una consonante. ¿Ok? Como el verbo study, estudiar, ¿ok? Termina en Y, pero antes de la Y va una D, una consonante. Entonces ahí sufre la modificación.
Thank you.
All right, you're welcome. Good. Bien, entonces, let me see. I'm going to pass the attendance list. Voy a pasar la lista de asistencia one more time. And we're free to go. Carla Lisette.
Present.
Thank you. Carlos Eduardo. Thank you. Carlos Gualberto.
Present.
Thank you. Dalila Abigail. Tania Rebeca. Okay. Give me a second. Where did I say? Perdí la lista. Eric Jonathan. Eric Jonathan.
Present.
Ah, okay. Thank you, Mr. Giovanni Pineda. All right, give me a second. Eric, can you please turn off your microphone, please? Okay, thank you, Mr. Okay, good. Giovanni Pineda.
Present.
Thank you. Giovanni Ramirez.
Present.
Thank you. Juan Carlos Palacios.
Present.
Thank you. Juan Carlos Peña.
Present.
Thank you. Juan Osmel.
Present.
Okay, thank you. Let me see, by the way, Juan Osmel. Juan Osmel, today, you're gonna have the 10 minutes feedback, okay? Se me queda después de clase.
Okay.
Okay, thank you. Kevin Antonio.
Present.
Thank you. Miguel Ángel.
Present.
Thank you. Nancy Yvette.
Present.
Okay, thank you. Let's see. say Marlon Alberto. Who can talk from here? Marlon, you there?
Present.
Okay, thank you. Omar.
Present.
Thank you, Omar. Silvia Zuleima.
Present.
Thank you, Silvia. Zuleima Verónica.
Present.
Thank you, ma'am. And Walter Daniel.
Present.
Okay, very good. Thank you, mister. Okay, cool. So, do we have any question related to the class? ¿Tenemos alguna pregunta antes de irnos? Or everything is clear? Okay, perfect. So your silence makes me think that everything is okay. Good. Entonces, no olvidemos, para mañana durante el día podemos hacer lo del midterm. Okay. Tenemos hasta mañana, al igual que las tareas, okay, en la plataforma. Entonces, that will be everything. Entonces, que tengan una excelente noche. Nos vemos mañana en la última videoconferencia de la semana, ¿ok? Have a wonderful night.
Teacher. Buenas noches.
Ok, bye. Teacher. Bye. Ya, yeah. Tell me, Eric.
Cualquier consulta que tengamos, le podemos escribir.
Claro que sí, en el grupo de WhatsApp.
Listo, entonces.
Ok, o al personal, como guste, ¿ok?
Ok.
All right, perfect, Eric.
Good night, teacher.
Okay, good night.
Good night.
Good night.
Una última consulta, teacher.
Yeah, tell me.
Hasta las 11:59 estaría habilitado el midterm.
¿Para mañana? Mm-hmm. Yeah.
Sí.
Okay. Yeah.
Okay. Gracias.
Okay.
Good night.
Bye bye. Okay, see you tomorrow, people. Okay, Juan. Let me see. I'm just giving you the directions. We're gonna have 10 minutes, okay? Just to provide feedback. Just give me a second. I think Mr. Omar.
Okay, teacher.
Bien, entonces estos 10 minutos, Juan, son básicamente para aclarar cualquier duda que usted pueda tener con relación a la clase, okay? En las clases anteriores que hemos tenido esta semana, las de la semana pasada, ok, so, entonces tiene 10 minutos para hacerme cualquier pregunta que usted haya tenido dudas al respecto, and I'm here to clarify, ok.
Fíjese, teacher, que sinceramente, pues gracias a Dios, todo me va quedando claro, ¿verdad?
Ajá.
Y como parte de lo que estamos viendo, la gran mayoría ya lo había visto en la universidad.
Ah, ok.
Por eso prácticamente ahorita me está sirviendo mucho de refuerzo esto. Me está sirviendo mucho de refuerzo, ¿verdad?
That's excellent.
Quiero ver. Ajá, la verdad sí he comprendido muy bien todo hasta el momento.
Ah, perfecto, perfecto. Me alegra escuchar eso entonces. Sí, porque básicamente los 10 minutos es para aclarar cualquier duda que usted pudiera tener con relación a la clase. Okay. ¿Cómo vamos en la plataforma? Ajá.
En la plataforma estaba viendo que voy al día, ¿verdad?
Uh-huh.
Pero tengo una duda. Estaba verificando ahí, no sé si hay un porcentaje que, si nos aparece el porcentaje de asistencia que hemos tenido a las clases, ¿verdad?
Uh-huh. Ajá.
Voy a verificar si puedo cargarlo, permítame.
Ok, ok.
Para mostrarle.
Ok, show me.
Estoy en la sección de progreso. Okay.
Give me a second. I'm gonna share my
screen. ¿Cómo acá?
Entonces voy a compartir mi pantalla. Don't worry about it. Permítame, voy a compartir mi pantalla para que la veamos.
Va, perfecto.
Un tanto claro. Let's see. Here we go. Acá tenemos ya. En la sección de progreso, ¿cierto?
Sí.
Ah, ok.
No sé qué significan todas estas barras que están en la gráfica.
Ok, que le aparece una H, una W y luego 01, HW02, HW03, HW04, HW de promedio, midterm, final, ajá, and total, ¿verdad?
Sí, sí.
Perfect, good. En la primera barra, ¿cuánto tiene?
Tengo un 100%.
Good. Entonces, la H y la W significa homework, tarea 1, tarea de la semana 1. Significa que ese 100% significa que usted cumplió con todas las tareas de todos los días de la semana pasada. Homework 2 o homework 2 es de la semana 2, o sea, de esta semana que estamos ahorita. ¿Ok? Homework 3 de la siguiente semana. Homework 4 de la última semana que vamos a tener. Y luego,
comprendo.
Ajá. Y luego tenemos homework, luego HW y luego promedio. Y luego tenemos midterm. El midterm, cuando mañana usted me haga el examen de medio curso, aquí en midterm le va a aparecer la gráfica de 100%, ¿ok? Cuando usted lo termine. Entonces, básicamente esas gráficas son básicamente es la, para mostrarle, ¿ok? Para mostrarle su progreso en tiempo real. ¿Cuánto usted ha avanzado por semana? Okay. Si baja,
voy bien en la semana 2, que llevo un 60%, creo que no, entonces debería llevar un 80%, ¿verdad?
¿Ha hecho las actividades de este día?
Las de este día aún no.
Ah, por eso es que no le aparece eso.
Ajá.
Por eso es. Entonces, culminando este día y ya mañana, ya le va a quedar el 100%.
Ah, comprendo. Yo pensé que esto reflejaba mi porcentaje de asistencia.
No, en este caso no es asistencia. Es la entrega de tareas que usted realiza.
Ah, comprendo.
Uh-huh.
Esa es la duda que tenía yo prácticamente por el momento, teacher.
Ah, ok. Vamos a ver su desempeño. Just give me a second, ok? I want to see your... Quiero ver... ¿Cómo vamos con las tareas? I want to see your development. Porque acá igual yo tengo acceso para revisar.
Ok.
Ah, ok, ya. Yeah. Bueno, Smell. Ajá, tiene el 60% y 40% del promedio. Ok, good. Sí, vamos bien entonces, Juan.
Ah, ok.
Very good. Entonces, para mañana igual. Entonces ya quedaría, as I told you, entonces ya quedaría abierto aquí en la sección 2 para el examen de medio curso, ¿ok? Que sería este. Entonces culminando este ya pues ya su nota va a ir incrementando también, ¿ok?
Ese examen debe estar hecho antes de las 11 según me parece, ¿verdad?
Yes, tiene que ser para mañana. Uh-huh.
Ah, ok, porque, está bien entonces, teacher.
Sí, porque ya mañana pues se suben notas. ¿Ok? Y pues ya va la nota del examen ahí incluida, porque se tienen que enviar esas notas. Ajá.
Ok, entonces, muchas gracias.
Ok, you're welcome, mister. See you tomorrow.
Okay. Ya no lo puedo escuchar porque comenzó a llover.
Ah, ok, entonces, nos vemos mañana.
Bueno, good evening.
Ok.
Good night.
Good night. All right, so basically today we were practicing, okay, vocabulary related to daily routines, okay? This vocabulary is very important to practice because from here we can have a very, very good way to show how to give okay, the activities that we do during a day. This is part of what we were discussing. Daily routines, vocabulary. We got hang the clothes. Hang the clothes like colgar la ropa. Ganchos, por así decirlo. Iron the clothes, like planchar la ropa. Make the bed, okay? Like preparar la cama, okay? Ordenar la cama, as you want to say. Go to bed, like ir a la cama o dormir. Wake up, despertarse. Brush the teeth, cepillarse los dientes. Drive to work, okay? Like conducir. Get home, llegar a casa, brush your hair, like peinarse el cabello, surf the net, navegar en internet, wash the car, lavar el carro, get dressed, vestirse, go out with a friend, like salir con un amigo, take pictures, tomar fotografías, play the guitar, okay, tocar la guitarra, water the plants, like regar las plantas, go for a walk, ir a un paseo. So, básicamente es un vocabulario esencial que nosotros debemos aprender para poder hablar sobre nuestras actividades diarias, okay? Actividades que generalmente son muy comunes para nosotros puesto que las hacemos todos los días, okay? So tomorrow we will have a practice, mañana vamos a tener una práctica de ello, okay? Con pequeñas conversaciones y pequeñas oraciones. So that's it for today. See you tomorrow. Bye bye.